Here he comes, here he comes.
I would disagree ferociously. I would even go as far as to challenge you to a knife fight. You want to come and talk some shit like that? We will tie our wrists together and solve this in the time on
our... Oh, God.
Holy shit. Two guys on the side far off.
Now then, change the tack for one special moment. Well, we all know the part of being a man is to call it nature. Kill it and serve it grill it. I've been hunting since I was a small boy, and I can in fact track more than 16 different species of ruminant animal. While our olfactory senses have been dulled as hell by so-called civilization, in nature, all they got is smell. I know how to simulate the odor of any species. I rub the pheromones all over my member. Trust me, when you have a young dog,
oh God.
Sexual awakening, run out of the woods filled with a yearning it scarcely understands, well, it really is something special.
Holy fuck.
That's a drop.
pollution. From a big leak to hushed up. Pay's triple and I need the money. Anyway, my boy's serving overseas.
Oh, Marines.
Nah.
Navy?
No, he's serving his sentence overseas in Burma. Those bastards put him away from being an entrepreneur. He's a patriot. He got in trouble here in Blaine County.
There we go. See, that is an enlightening and instructive.
Are we gonna blow out yet?
Excessive travel. Multiculturalism is heathenism. God had wanted us to co-mingle. He would have invented a land of opportunity where we could migrate and create a glorious monoculture. But that ain't happening because it ain't right. I will think of your boy when I am down on my knee tonight. I practice it every day. In case I ever come across a rundown roadside bar in a small town that said, now let us talk about it.
To the top of the mountain, they drove off, and we're endangering the public's fucking children, so we're gonna spend as much taxpayer money as possible. Look, we're watching Cops. Only the fucking AI cops are better. Filthy pig! Oh shit, you guys are not gonna believe this. At all. Like, seriously, I couldn't believe it.
The car says, ouch.
There's a man being charged with threatening to commit a crime because he put on his Facebook, in quotation marks, put wings on pigs. Yeah. And the cops are saying that, like, a verbal threat. And they arrested him, take him to court over, and try to charge him for threatening to commit a crime, which is a real charge, but all he said was, "Put wings on pigs," which is an actual quote from a man who just executed two police officers in their squad car last week. And he turned the gun on himself after he executed the officers. But they're saying that he executed the officers. The police are saying this, that he did it because he's been, you know, abused by police in the past, and he's been posting all that anti-police brutality shit on Facebook and Instagram for the past few weeks. And they're saying that's what it's for. And then his family members are saying, no, he's disturbed. He's disturbed. We had no idea he would do something like that, but we always knew he wasn't always all there, is what they're trying to tell them. And they're going to turn it into a whole big thing. But meanwhile, a cop who is retired and still good friends with many people on a certain police force in that area read that news and said, and posted to Facebook himself, "If you see this man, to any of my law enforcement friends, if you see this asshole, shoot his ass, or kill his ass." That's what he posted. So if "put wings on pigs" can be turned into killing an officer, threatening to kill an officer, don't you think a direct threat towards a specific person would get more jail time? So we'll see what the ex-cop gets and what the civilian gets, right? Double standards written all over it.